Uno, dos, tres.
It's been a really, really messed up week. 7 days of torture, 7 days of bitter. And my girlfriend went and cheated on me. She's a California dime, but it's time for me to quit her. La, 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 whatever. La, 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 it doesn't matter. La, 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 oh well. La, 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 we're going at it tonight. Tonight, there's a party on the rooftop, top of the world. Tonight, tonight, and we're dancing on the edge of the Hollywood sign. I don't know if I'll make it, but watch how good I'll fake it. It's alright, alright. I woke up with a strange tattoo. Not sure how I got it, not a dollar in my pocket. And it kinda looks just like you, mixed with Zach Galifianakis. La, 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 whatever. La, 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 it doesn't matter.
Roller skates and rollerblades are fundamentally different in terms of the type of wheels and their arrangement on the chassis of the skates. And that is why they are very different in their usage and have their own advantages and disadvantages. The main reason behind choosing such a product was to devise a low-cost product which can help the consumers to take advantages of both forms of skates and use any form as per the need. For example, roller skates are more useful for artistic acts and roller blades are more stable when it comes to skating on rocky terrain and when the speed is the prime focus. Therefore, we have attempted to bring to the user a product that he or she can modify as per his or her own needs and choice.
The first chassis that we made didn't fit properly with the bases of the rollers and the inline skates. Also, it was a bit ugly looking. So, we made a new chassis which will fit in properly with the bases of the rollers and the inline skates and would make the arrangement more stable. Now, we fitted in a shoe on the top of a metal sheet chassis because where the user can put in his or her feet. Now, we used a strap in the front part of the shoe because the arrangement was delicate from the front part of it. Now, we fitted in the shoe to the metal chassis with the help of two screws in the middle, which would make the arrangement more stable and the shoe would properly be attached to the chassis. We used the clay because there were sharp edges on the metal chassis and we don't want the customer to get injured.
We first thought of choosing a steel sheet over an aluminium sheet. However, using steel would have made our skates very, very heavy. That is why we went for aluminium to make the bases for both the skates.
Now coming to the part of the roller skate attachment. We first built four L-shaped thinner aluminium sheets which we would attach to the thicker aluminium sheet. We thought of welding it first, but since there is no such procedure available in the workshop to weld aluminium, we instead used rivets. Now, after the four L-shaped aluminium sheets were attached and made, we drilled in four holes and put in two axles and then we put in the wheels in the form of a roller skate. Now coming to the attachment of the inline skates. We bought four wheel attachments from the market. The problem that we faced was that the wheel attachments were able to rotate through 360 degree angle. But in the inline order arrangement, we needed the wheels to be arranged in a particular angle. So we welded these two parts from three sides so that they would be constrained in a particular angle and an inline arrangement would be possible. Then after the four wheels were welded and they were arranged in a particular angle, we arranged them in a straight line using drills and screws such that our arrangement is complete. After the roller skate attachment has been attached to the metal chassis, our skate is ready to roll. Now, how to convert our roller skate to our inline skate? We can simply unscrew the roller skate attachment easily. And then we can remove this attachment and put in the inline skate attachment. After this is done, we can again screw this. I'm showing you the demo with only one screw as it takes a lot of time to screw and unscrew. Now, our inline skate is also ready.
We learned quite a lot of things while making this project. But the best part was the exchange of ideas that took place among the various group members. There were times where there seemed to be no solution to a problem, but the interaction with the instructors really helped. Also, we realized that many a times the ideas need to be shaped and bent in such a way so as to meet the practical feasibility. Apart from just developing workshop skills, we developed a never giving up attitude in us, and we realized that hard work and dedication gives you happiness and joy that is unprecedented. Tonight, tonight, there's a party on the rooftop, top of the world.